I might be anyone, a lone fool out in the sun. Your heartbeat of solid gold, I love you, you'll never know. When the daylight comes, you feel so cold. You know I'm too afraid of my heart to let you go. Waiting for the fires you light, feeling like we could do I might be anyone, a lone fool out in the sun. Your heartbeat of solid gold, I love you, you'll never know. When the daylight comes, you feel so cold. You know I'm too afraid of my heart to let you go. Waiting for the fires you light, feeling like we could do right.
Just basically the little things in life make me happy. For instance, beautiful weather, sunshine, mm-hmm. especially in the Netherlands because it's raining here a lot. And that's basically it. I'm not a guy from big things and everything, but yeah, I like the small things in life.
If you had to sum up your attitude in like one single line, do you think you live by the day or you plan big, like you long term?
No, by the day, definitely. Yeah.
Partying with friends, going to music stuff.
Music festivals.
Plenty. No, not even the festivals, just the concerts of artists.
Well, I think more in a philosophical way, what makes me happy is real contact with people. It's basically that, actually. So I have friends, and maybe I should tell you a little bit of background. I've been traveling a lot the last few years, traveling and moving around to different places, and I saw the most beautiful spots, and I've been in great countries and met a lot of interesting people. But what I appreciated most are just my friends here in Holland, like the friends that I really know, and they know me, and so it's about contact, I think.
I do for fun. I like to do some sports, like play golf, which is not just boring, it's also fun. I play a lot of computer games, and I like... make me happy. Not being worried about stuff, that makes me happy.
Alright, what worries you though? What worries you? Like
very little. <That's a> good, I tend to simply not to worry about a lot of stuff.
It's for example in maybe 3 hours time when Holland will beat that would be really nice. It would make me really happy.
Oh yeah.
And there are a lot of things during the day which makes me really happy. A lot of small things. My child, for example, waking up, that he's waking up in the morning and I see him, those kind of things are just really nice. Other things I do like is that I have a small plot of land which I have an allotment, and I grow some vegetables and fruit, and those kind of things make me happy as well. And I go there every week and I see things.
How about ambition-wise? Like, is there anything towards that?
As a graphic designer, I just would like to make things pretty and to see things in the public, like making a website and looking at the statistics, analytics, and you can see a lot of traffic.
The Dutch people live and root for the present. For them, happiness is in the smallest of things as the day unfolds. Even a good weather will bring cheerfulness to all, which also brings about music and festivals, which is the biggest idea of party. They always avoid anything that causes worry and aspire for a good day. Very similar mindset among everybody, and their idea of ambition is no money, but a good, comfortable life.
At the moment, I am you will laugh, but I'm starting a 40-hour work week for a couple of months.
Yeah. India, please listen very carefully.
Yes. And I'm a little bit lazy. I actually prefer working 3 days a week, and now I have to work 5 days a week, 8-hour work days, and I have to travel a lot as well. So I probably have to travel an hour, maybe 1.5 hours to the work and then back. So there will be 3 hours of traveling, 8 hours working, and then maybe half an hour break. So 11, maybe 12 hours I'll be gone. And for me, that's that feels like a marathon.
Those are probably more work related. You know, do I actually do a good job at my work, and am I able to perform well enough? But in my personal life, not a lot of struggle. I'm always surprised about the amount of money people pay me for my work. So that amount of money, I can pretty much do what I like.
I want to write a book, and it's a struggle to start writing the book.
Uh-huh. Yeah. You will write it about adventures or something?
No,
like
no.
Harry Potter.
I want the Michael Bay stories.
Uh-huh.
Because the story and the essence of those movies are brilliant.
Isn't the same as Transformers?
Yeah. He wrote all sequels.
Alright.
And directed them. It's magnificent.
My struggle is discipline. I have none.
I think my struggle, I really don't like job interviews. Just a pain in the ass. too nerve-wracking, and I have to be able to present myself in, 20, 30 minutes. All the good things to impress the people sitting opposite of me. That's just nerve-wracking.
After listening to the answers, it can be safely said that the struggles are not really hindrances in daily life. Most of the people are content with their lifestyle, and their needs are mostly towards self-actualization and self-esteem.
It was recently I went to a breakcore evening of the Acid Night, which was rather loud, and I went completely sober because I had to be sober for a couple of days before another big event. And it was really intense. I just got high off the music.
I used to have a folding bike. It's stolen, but that's typical Dutch, by the way.
Stolen.
But I had a I had a folding bike. And I took
the man with the new folding bike.
Anyways, last year, because I really like cycling and I really like traveling, I decided to go to Spain on my folding bike, and on my own. And it was the first time I did a long trip on my bike. There was Spain is, I think it's about 1,400 kilometers, and it gets more hilly. Here everything is flat, but then it gets more hilly. So I just I made my backpack, put it on the back of my folding bike. Somehow in the morning I was like, how can I do that? Just like this. I just started pedaling, basically. And I thought, if I just keep on pedaling, then I'll get there. And that's what happened. And I was a little bit afraid about camping on my own, because I also put my tent on the back, and I bought little pans to cook and stuff, because I had no money to spend for hotels or anything. So, yeah, but it was amazing.
Well, hopefully in next Sunday will be a very memorable moment, because, you know, Holland being world champion would be something I will I have on my list. If that would ever happen, it's probably never going to happen. Most memorable, otherwise. Some of the more legendary moments are probably on music festivals. You know, probably the first time I went to a festival like Lowlands, that was amazing. You know, but I was 20, and you see this entire world of fun and music, and it's certainly very memorable.
In my life?
Or Patrick's, like.
The sorry, it's work for me, yeah. So. He become my assistant yet.
Oh!
Yeah, can you finish those things?
And then later, you know, give him a massage or something. Alright.
The most memorable moment in my life. And there are a lot of things in my life that I think that are memorable.
Something that pops up like right now, one of the first things on your mind?
Yesterday, 2 victory of Lars Boom, the cyclist.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, we don't know Tour de France, yeah. You'll have to change.
Yeah, we have
we don't accept
a
this.
Big race, it's called Tour de France. And there, a Dutch guy won yesterday.
Huh?
It's a special memorable because the Netherlands lost yesterday the World Championships and I'm still...
Semi-finals. Against Argentina, with penalties.
So.
That's kind of cliche as well, but it's probably the birth of my son. Getting married, those are like really big events, and just being able to move on my own to a big city, and just be able to manage there, just to build up a life. Just,
the answers exhibit the sense of adventure in them. Memorable experiences are seen not as moments of pride, but as joyous occasions that they want to relive.
Who can say where the road goes, where the day flows, only time? And who can say?